Hello, my name is Thomas Drake, and I'm president of Tradition Family Property Louisiana. Tradition Family Property Louisiana is an organization of American lay Catholics concerned with the moral crisis devastating the Catholic Church and remnants of Christian civilization.
Back in January 1971, the first members of the American Society for the Defense of Tradition, Family, and Property, TFP, started a group in New York around the publication Crusade for a Christian Civilization. Today, with over 120,000 members, volunteers, and donors, the American TFP is on the front lines of the culture war, legally and peacefully defending the values of tradition, family, and private ownership. TFP Student Action is an important outreach of the American TFP.
In 2003, the American TFP published an analysis of the Supreme Court's Lawrence versus Texas decision that legalized sodomy. The TFP called it America's moral 9/11. In opposition to Pope Leo XIII's definition of ordered liberty in the encyclical Libertas, Lawrence versus Texas sees liberty as license and anarchy. All state laws proscribing moral evils such as prostitution, adultery, bigamy, incest, sadomasochism, pedophilia, and bestiality were placed at risk. In 2004, the American TFP published the book Defending a Higher Law, Why We Must Resist Same-Sex Marriage and the Homosexual Movement. It is a handbook for opponents of the homosexual revolution. It discusses the origins, history, and tactics of the homosexual movement and gives conservatives the arguments to fight back. In 2008, the American TFP published Battling for America's Soul, How Homosexual Marriage Threatens Our Nation and Faith. The TFP urges lawful and conscientious resistance.
In June 2018, the American Library Association held its annual conference and exhibition in New Orleans. Former First Lady Michelle Obama opened the event. The Drag Queen Story Hour idea was promoted to the 17,000 people attending. Soon after, the Lafayette Public Library reached out to Delta Lambda Phi, the University of Louisiana Lafayette GBT fraternity, and to professional drag queens to read gender-fluid books to children as young as three. It was then advertised in the library newsletter. The news of a planned drag queen story time at the main public library broke shortly before the August 21st, 2018, public meeting of the Lafayette City Parish Council. A strong community reaction began to express itself, mostly by email and phone, to the library, to the city parish president, and to the city councilors. The LGBT activists, however, have been preparing for months. They packed the City Hall auditorium so that 19 out of 20 speakers pushed for the drag queen story time. And the media promoted the coup as popular support and demand for the event by the community.
A truly great library has something in it to offend everyone. When you try to rise up against a group of people who have shown no hate, no history of violence against anyone, and you tell them that they do not belong in a public space, you will not be viewed kindly in the history books.
In reality, most parents in Lafayette were just waking up to what was happening. The great majority of people were not in favor of active homosexuals in drag reading gender-fluid storybooks to 3 to 6-year-olds. Although the public was shocked, it was not ready to express itself.
We talked to people everywhere. Cashiers, teachers, mothers, clergy, and students on campus. Attorneys and other professionals. People of all ages and walks of life. They were all against it, but didn't know what to do. Worthy organizations were doing what they could, but the intensity and suddenness of the attack caught everyone by surprise.
The very boldness of the radical LGBT onslaught helped bring together a citizens' coalition. And as the issue became more widely known, the resistance began to snowball. The first TFP-Louisiana Rosary Rally of protest and reparation took place on August 25th on the edge of the University of Louisiana Lafayette campus, not far from the main public library, where the Drag Queen Storytime was scheduled for October 6th. The prayer rally broke the climate of fear of speaking out. The community soon learned that public libraries receive millions of dollars of taxpayer money through city councils, but city councils have no say over how the funds are spent. The revelation that your hometown library could be harnessed as a vehicle for revolutionary social change was an eye-opener for many. The tax dollars were being used, added insult to injury. Our children are corrupted, and we are expected to pay for it too. With help from TFP Student Action, TFP Louisiana started a petition to the American Library Association, the Lafayette Public Library Board of Control, and the Lafayette City Parish President and Council members to stop the Drag Queen Storytime. More than 17,000 signed on in 3 weeks. The signatures were presented to the Public Library Board of Control and Teresa Elberson, the head librarian.
So you made the decision to put it on the...
Yes, sir.
Okay.
On September 17th, this was the first opportunity for the public to have a say in the library's decision to not just host, but endorse the Drag Queen Storytime. On September 18th, the petition was delivered to the mayor-president of Lafayette City Parish, Mr. Joel Robideau, and the city parish councilors at the monthly public meeting. The media were in full force at both events, but ignored the petition to stop the Drag Queen Storytime. 40 pastors, and sad to say, none were Catholic, asked the council to take a public stand. So two of the city parish councilors put forward a non-binding motion to denounce the Drag Queen Storytime hosted at the tax-funded public library. Three councilors opposed the Drag Queen Storytime, the other six abstained.
Mr. Chair, we did have 101 citizen who did not wish to speak, who signed in to support the resolution, and we did have 24 citizens who did not wish to speak, who signed in opposition to the resolution. And likewise, there were 63 citizens who called the council office to state their support against the resolution, and 209 for the resolution. Our first speaker.
In my troop, we have what is called a bearded queen, and she models her drag after, yes, Annie Jones, the bearded woman from the famous freak shows of the 19th century.
Romans 10:13 says, "For all who call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Come, listen to me read. Listen to my sisters and brothers read."
There's nothing wrong with dressing in drag. There's nothing wrong with gender fluidity. They're not at risk because of who they love, what they wear, who they have sex with.
My name is Dr. Keith Dorwick, and I am surprised to find out tonight that I do not, in fact, exist. I am somatically male. That is, I have the chromosomes that any male would have. However, I don't identify as male because I don't feel that that's complex or rich enough.
Drag is an art. It's a performance. And it is not propagating sex. And for me, standing here supporting Drag Queen Storytime, if that means that you think that I'm going to go to hell, then so be it.
I'm Zach Sasser. I'm the pastor at First Presbyterian Church. I'm here to speak against the resolution. Those who oppose this may be on the side of damnation. You'd have to clear a spot for me, too, if you're going to go there for loving people. I want to just tell you three quick stories about three different children. One was one that I saw holding a sign across from my sanctuary, across from my church the other day, with a group who was opposing this story time. I'm guessing he was around 8 years old, and he was holding a sign condemning other creatures made in God's image with the authority of God, because his parents brought him out there to do that.
Lying Lunsford.
Sir.
Mike Works.
Sir. Let's not name call anybody, please.
I'm in drag right now. It's just not flamboyant. I'm not sure my own grandkids, I have four, have seen me out of drag. 3 to 6 is absolutely the right age group for this.
This is going to be the grooming of the next generation. This is going to be the grooming of the next generation.
But the tide of public opinion had turned. The community was now alert and reacting. At this monthly public meeting of the City Parish Council, the LGBT activists arrived to find the auditorium now packed beyond capacity and spilling out into the hallways.
How many of you support the resolution asking your council members to take a position? Please raise your hand. Okay. Thank you all very much. That's all I have for now. I'll tender any further questions.
Another conservative group, Citizens for a New Louisiana, had a petition to the City Parish Council concerned about the taxpayer-funded Dry Queen Storytime. After its presentation to the council, LGBT activists obtained the names, addresses, emails, and phone numbers of those on that petition and posted them on Reddit for public harassment. Then, on September 27th, the library announced it was no longer hosting Dry Queen Storytime. Rather, it was being moved to the South Louisiana Community College, still scheduled for October 6. The spin was that the move would accommodate the expected overflow crowds just dying to see the Dry Queen Storytime. The move to a tax-funded state community college backfired. Now state politicians had a say. It was no longer a city issue, but a state one. From politicians at the state capitol to Louisianans of every background, the opposition kept growing. 48 hours before its performance, the Dry Queen Storytime event was canceled. The rosy rally of reparation and protest were now changed to a public act of thanksgiving. Demoralized but unwavering, the LGBT activists went underground, hoping the public would forget the issue. Then on Super Bowl Sunday, February 3rd, 2019, they tried to pull a fast one, holding a Drag Queen Storytime at the Lafayette Public Library, South Regional. However, good families were on the ready. 80 peaceful, law-abiding citizens from every walk of life protested the corruption of children's innocence with gender ideology on this Super Bowl Sunday. They outnumbered the 30-odd adults, ushering a dozen poor children into a room inside the library. Where were the crowds of Drag Queen Storytime supporters, trumpeted for months by the local and national media? It was all propaganda. The hype was meant to cower the average parent into thinking that the LGBT juggernaut was unstoppable. The protests, however, revealed its clay feet. The enthusiastic honking of Sunday drivers in support of the public square rosary of reparation in front of the library was seen and heard by the crews of the three local TV channels. Still, not one of them reported on this. Public awareness is now greater than before, but the issue is far from over.
Thank you. Trying to convince a child that he or she can change his or her sex or gender based on their emotions is a special form of child abuse. What they're doing here, this, again, Drag Queen Story Time, Story Hour, is a national campaign. This is happening all across the country. And the intent is to erode the moral sense of the public, to make us let down our guard, the natural inherent sense that we have, that doesn't make any sense. And so we have no choice but to stand here and to fight against that. Otherwise, we would be complicit in allowing that moral degradation to advance.
The American TFP and America Needs Fatima alone organized 182 public prayer rallies across the country in 2018 and 2019. In New Orleans, Baton Rouge, Houston, Dallas, Cincinnati, Chicago, San Francisco, Pittsburgh, a growing movement of Ten Commandment Americans let go of the shackles of fear and spoke out, no longer intimidated by the mockery, name-calling, and bully tactics of a destructive few.
As mentioned, we were not alone. Many other conservative groups were involved, and fought the good fight. In the Bayou State, the Louisiana Family Forum and the American Family Association, among others, engaged their grassroots. Many prayer and Bible study groups were also very active.
The mass media push for the transgender revolution shows clearly that this is the new spearhead, the latest step in demolishing what is left of Western Christian civilization. The transgender is the new human type. Whether it's in sports, entertainment, college campuses, or politics, the T in LGBT is the new idol everyone is forced to worship. They want your children. The decriminalization of pedophilia comes next. More than any other issue, the Drag Queen Story Hour has been and is a compass of the direction our country will go.
This is going to be the grooming of the next generation.
The David French versus Sohrab Ahmari debate at Catholic University in September 2019 shows how this issue rattles the very foundations of America. We must fight back, always legally and peacefully, if we hope to keep America one nation under God.
The Summit for Survivors of the Sexual Revolution is a one-of-a-kind annual event created by the Ruth Institute to empower individuals and families harmed by divorce, the hookup culture, and other forms of family breakdown. Every year we bring activists, experts, and victims together to understand the damage the sexual revolution has caused. Subscribe for weekly videos or visit our website for more details. Thank you for watching.